Ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
The biggest names in music.
Oh, wow.
Big names. Big songs. Big guests. Big prizes.
Well, it's a big show.
The Big Show.
Put your hands together for the one and only
Glenn, Angel, FD, and Sean.
That's what I'm talking about!
1FM 91.33. Good times, greatest hits.
Good morning, Singapore. Welcome to a beautiful Wednesday morning. And boy, do we have an amazing lineup of guests in the next hour. All right. It is the 21st of April, 2021. We kick off this morning with Dr. Ronnie Tan, urologist from Mount Elizabeth and Parkway East Hospitals. And he is joining us this morning to talk about testosterone deficiency, or TD, diabetes, and metabolic syndrome. A very good morning to you, Dr. Ronnie Tan.
Good morning, Glenn.
Thanks so much for joining us, Doctor. There are many reasons why men should get treated for TD or testosterone deficiency. And one known reason is preventing the progression and development of diabetes and metabolic syndrome. How is TD actually related to diabetes and the metabolic syndrome? How does treating TD prevent the progression and development of diabetes and metabolic syndrome?
We know that patients with low testosterone, those patients with testosterone deficiency or TD, they are also at higher risk of having insulin resistance. And because of insulin resistance, they end up with bad sugar control, and clinically that's what I call diabetes. All right. And also for men with low testosterone, they also have some endothelial dysfunction. As a result, there are problems with the blood vessels. They are at higher risk of having plaques in the blood vessels. So that puts them at higher risk of hypertension, hyperlipidemia, which is two of the components that make up metabolic syndrome. So the third component of metabolic syndrome is actually diabetes. So there's a bit of overlap in these conditions.
But how do we know, Doctor, if we truly have a deficiency as far as our testosterone is concerned?
Okay. So the clinical manifestation of testosterone deficiency will be the fact that the patient has some sexual dysfunction. Most commonly will be things like erectile dysfunction, loss of morning erections. And also these men also find that their sex drive or libido is low. And other, I would call it a non-sexual manifestation will be things like decrease in energy levels. They find that they're losing their muscle mass and they're putting on a bit of weight.
Okay,
but of course these are just signs. They're not definitive, right? You know, people might be experiencing these things maybe based on psychological issues. So to be absolutely sure, is there a way for us to test if we are indeed testosterone deficient?
Yes. So in addition to these symptoms, when you present yourself to a doctor. After asking all these symptoms, they will probably get a blood test. So they'll draw the testosterone levels, what I call the serum testosterone levels. And these blood tests should be done in the morning between the hours of 7 to 11. Because testosterone has a diurnal variation. That means in the morning, actually, it peaks. Which explains why men will wake up with a morning erections because of the surge of the testosterone. Right. So we always want to catch it in the highest level so that we can determine whether the testosterone is actually low.
Okay. We are talking to Dr. Ronnie Tan, and we're so privileged to have him on the show today. He, of course, is a urologist from Mount Elizabeth and Parkway East Hospitals. We'll continue our conversation with Dr. Tan live on Facebook on thebigshow.tv. Meantime, here's Kathy Dennis, Touch Me All Night Long on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. Good morning, Singapore.
So, Dr. Tan, if a man does find out that he is testosterone deficient and then gets treatment for it, is this an effective therapeutic approach to actually managing diabetes and metabolic syndromes?
Okay. First of all, we shouldn't be mistaken that we're using testosterone to treat diabetes. So, the diabetic man still has to be treated with the usual medications used to control the sugars. So we find that this, because like I mentioned, testosterone deficiency has an overlap with metabolic syndrome, and one of the components of metabolic syndrome would be diabetes. So if we bring the man's testosterone levels to the normal levels, we're not talking about super physiological levels, we bring it up to the normal levels, we find that the control of the sugars, control of the blood pressure, as well as his cholesterol, actually improves.
Okay.
Yeah. So in a way, treating these diabetic men with testosterone deficiency is a way of augmenting the treatment so that he benefits first from the sugar control and also from his other symptoms that he may manifest because of TD.
Okay, I just have a question based on what you just said. Does it go the other way around, that those with metabolic syndromes and syndrome and diabetes also might be at risk of testosterone deficiency?
Yes, they up to about probably about 15 to 25% of diabetic men may have testosterone deficiency.
Okay.
Yeah. So especially if these patients present to the family physicians or the GPs, who are treating them for diabetes, if they start to tell that they have some of these sexual symptoms or some of the other symptoms, like I mentioned, decreased energy levels and sex drive, we're actually prompting the GPs, maybe they should check the testosterone levels just to make sure that the patient doesn't have TD at the same time.
So it is encouraged if you are a diabetic to get your testosterone levels checked. Now, the question is, how often do I get my testosterone levels checked? Is it just a one-time check, or do I continuously have to do it year after year?
All right. So typically for testosterone checks, we will encourage when there are symptoms, especially, or we find that the control of the diabetes is not as well as what you want it to be. So a one-time check, let's say, for example, it comes back as equivocal, that means it's not really that high, but not really too low. What we encourage is that we should repeat the testosterone maybe about 2 months' time to see how the trend is like.
Mm.
Yeah. So let's say, for example, if the trend shows that it's actually uptrending or it's coming to normal and the patient doesn't have symptoms, then of course there's no need to follow up.
Mm.
But let's say, for example, the patient just wanted to have a check, it was normal, then along the way he has symptoms, then when the symptoms come on, then it's a good time to check, and if it's low, then we'll start treating. Because for the treatment of testosterone deficiency, it's very important that we do regular 3 monthly checks of the testosterone levels. In addition to that, at the initiation of the testosterone deficiency treatment, we also need to check the PSA, which is a prostate-specific antigen.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of the cancer markers for prostate cancer. However, that doesn't mean that testosterone causes prostate cancer. It's just that in some men, when we treat with testosterone, the PSA levels can be a little bit more difficult to interpret, and we need to follow up on that. So the other blood test that we will check will be what I call hematocrit. Basically, it's how thick the blood is. Because testosterone has an effect on the bone marrow and makes the patient produce more red blood cells.
So another question I would ask then is, for the older people watching us and listening to us right now, those with a heart condition, can they still get testosterone treatment?
Okay. Studies have shown that men who have low testosterone that's not being treated, they'll be at higher risk of having heart conditions.
Mm.
Let's say, for example, the patient already has a heart condition, it's on follow-up with a cardiologist or the family physician. Usually, we will check the testosterone levels, and then we will discuss with the patient, first of all, how severe the symptoms are.
Mm.
And because the studies at this point does not show that giving testosterone will worsen the cardiovascular disease, or rather, if it's low and it's not treated, they are at higher risk.
Mm.
So usually, we'll sit down and tell the patient exactly what we are trying to achieve here. Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
I see. You might want to ask Dr. Tan that question once again when we go live on Facebook.
Yeah,
maybe together with is treating TD an effective therapeutic approach.
Yeah.
But now, I mean, we are live on the bigshow.tv, not on air. I want to ask you this, Dr. Tan. You know, there's so many supplements out there that claim that if you take these testosterone supplements, you'll be all right.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Is it truly effective? I mean, it can't, right? Because, I mean, surely it's a bit more complicated than that, right?
Yeah. So for the treatment of the testosterone deficiency, we usually will treat the patient with testosterone, and it has to be a prescribed medication. It's not something you can just buy off the shelves. So the treatment of testosterone, we have oral tablets, we have topicals where the patient applies a gel on himself every day versus injectables. So for injectables, you have the short-acting and the long-acting. We used to use a bit of the short-acting, which the patient requires an injection every 2 weeks.
Mm.
So the problem with that is that the levels go up and down.
Mm.
And when the patient comes back, when the levels are low, they feel really down. So now we are encouraging to use long-acting, more sustained injections, but the patient only requires injections every 3 months, so it's up to about four injections a year.
Right.
Doc, is there any natural way to boost our testosterone? Like, I know exercise does it, but is there anything like you can consume? Fruits, vegetables, I don't know.
Whole foods.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exercise, definitely. We're talking about over-exercising. Because studies have shown that in those cases where, for example, some of these men who are really exercising for very, very intense sports, if they overdo it, sometimes the testosterone can dip. But we're talking about every day, just keep yourself healthy. It's actually a good idea.
Yeah.
Like if you do 3 classes a day, it's much.
See,
some
Sean,
people,
I've been telling you, Sean, you know, too much exercise is not good.
I'm talking about you. Okay, wait, go back on air.
OneFM 91.3 was having such a great time on thebigshow.tv with Dr. Ronnie Tan. If you're watching us and listening to us, good for you! Right after Dr. Ronnie, of course, we'll be joined by Gurmit Singh as well. But for now, we are talking about testosterone deficiency, diabetes and metabolic syndrome to Dr. Ronnie Tan, urologist from Mount Elizabeth and Parkway East Hospitals.
So we were talking about this, and I think it's really interesting because I've got a question that'll follow up. So are there foods we can eat that will raise our testosterone levels?
I don't think there's any food that actually raises the testosterone level. So we shouldn't be going out to buy all the bull testicles and
exactly.
Yeah.
But we did say that regular exercise does help.
Yes,
Not too much,
though. Yeah. Okay, my question.
I think Dr. Ronnie should, Dr. Tan should expand a little bit about that, because many people are exercising like crazy these days, thinking that you know, extreme exercise can reverse many conditions.
Yes,
you know. So if we're just talking about testosterone, could you repeat what you told us live on thebigshow.tv about too much exercise, Dr. Tan?
Yeah, because there are some studies who show that if the patient does very very extreme exercises. And there's an overkill of exercise. They found that testosterone can dip in some of these, even in athletes.
Wow.
So we're talking about, let's say if you're doing your regular exercise, just keep yourself healthy. It's actually a good idea because it's also good for your cardiovascular health.
So cardiovascular health, doctor, can people who have a heart condition and are on their blood thinners and all the other things that they take, can they, if they have testosterone deficiency, can they take the medication?
Okay. So patients with cardiac conditions, they'll probably be either on follow-up with their cardiologist or a family physician who's taking care of them. So we know that if a man has low testosterone that is not treated, his risk of cardiovascular events does increase. But for those patients who are currently having these issues and they find that they have low testosterone with symptoms, they should discuss with their cardiologist. And usually for those patients that come to us, urologists to talk about testosterone deficiency, if we find that they also have cardiac disease, we actually work hand in hand with the cardiologist to make sure that the patient is suitable.
So when I go to my GP and he will give me the blood test to find out whether my testosterone levels are low or whatever, is he treating me or will he then send me to a urologist?
Okay. So it depends on whether your GP is comfortable with testosterone.
Yeah.
So usually we tell the family physicians if they find that they are ready to follow up the patients with regular blood tests, usually every 3 months when you're using injectable testosterone, then he can proceed. Let's say, for example, at the initiation of the treatment, usually we'll do some blood tests. Other than the testosterone levels, we also check the PSA, which is the prostate specific antigen, which is commonly known as a cancer marker for prostate cancer.
Mm.
So, for example, if before he starts, he finds that the PSA is abnormal, usually we'll encourage them to just refer to the urologist so we can take care of the patient together. Okay. Because elevated PSA requires further investigations.
All right. You've been talking about heart patients and all that, FD, but I just want to come back to diabetic patients.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. So would you encourage all diabetic men, Dr. Tan, to check their testosterone levels and get treated? And when should they get checked and treated?
Okay. So if these men already have the symptoms suggestive of testosterone deficiency, like we mentioned, the sexual symptoms and the non-sexual symptoms, yes, they should request for the testosterone to be checked. The other group of diabetic men who should have their testosterone checked will be those who find that the sugar controls are not so good. So we are encouraging the family physician and the GPs to actually sound out these patients and then actually check the testosterone levels.
Okay.
All right. We are talking to Dr. Ronnie Tan. Of course, he is from Mount Elizabeth and Parkway East Hospital about testosterone deficiency, diabetes, and metabolic syndrome. We'll continue this conversation live on TheBigShow.tv. Meantime, here's Culture Club. Do you really want to hurt me? On The Big Show, 1FM 91.3.
Okay, so Dr. Tan, we're talking about this testosterone deficiency, diabetes, as well as metabolic syndrome. So clearly this is a topic that's quite relevant. But in terms of numbers, how big is this group in Singapore that is diabetic men with testosterone deficiency?
Okay, so just looking at diabetes alone, I did a check on our Singaporean websites and we found that in 2014, we already have 440,000 Singapore residents above the age of 18 years old who have diabetes. And it's estimated that this number can grow up to 1 million by 2050.
This is so men and women or men only?
Men and women,
Men and women, okay.
Men and women. So just diabetes alone is actually a global issue. And we find that diabetes accounts for up to about 10% of the disease burden in Singapore. And the prevalence in Singapore is 10.5%, which is actually higher and the world's average of 8.8%. So you're talking about the percentage of diabetic men who have low testosterone is reported to about 15 to 25%.
Okay, so I mean, you said that was from 2014, is it? 2014.
Yeah.
So has that number been increasing or decreasing over the years? And if it's gone either way, why do you think that is?
Yeah, so I think diabetes is definitely increasing because we know that with affluence, and kind of food that we are taking, and we are so comfortable these days, you know. Increased waist circumference also has resulted in patients with diabetes.
Yes. That's why all the exercising.
Yes. So I think it's a good thing that we now know that diabetes is an issue, and I think island wide everybody is trying to try to improve our health, and then the Health Promotion Board is really telling patients to get themselves checked for high sugar levels, just make sure they are not pre-diabetic. Because studies have shown that those in pre-diabetic patients who also have testosterone deficiency, if the testosterone is treated, they can find that the sugars actually come down. They may not even need treatment for diabetes. Oh, but then I guess again, testosterone treatment is not used just to treat diabetes, but it does help, I would say, with the sugar control.
So as with anything, catching it early is always a good idea, right?
Yes. Sure.
Okay. Is there such a thing as having too much testosterone?
I mean, I was about to ask. Yeah,
explode.
Okay. For having too much testosterone, we are talking about whether it is an innate thing or is it something that you're giving yourself too many injections. So we have seen cases where some men are using testosterone not for medical purpose but to try to improve. Muscle bulk and all that. So the problem with giving yourself testosterone over the charts, patients will end up with things like severe acne and usually it's on the back. And a lot of these patients who use testosterone, because they inject themselves testosterone, they will actually become subfertile. They will not be able to produce any sperm in the semen. And then they can't have children. Yeah, and sometimes it takes at least 6 months to a year for the testicle to actually regain its function in terms of
the... Wow.
Okay, Dr. Tan, I just wanted to ask you, I mean, we know about like blood pressure measurements and levels and all that, but how is testosterone measured? Is it out of 100? Is it over 36? Or how do you know what's a good level?
Okay, so testosterone levels are tested when you draw blood and looking at the serum levels,
Okay, all right.
So a diabetic person or someone with metabolic syndrome has testosterone deficiency and goes for treatment. What happens if they stop the testosterone treatment? Does everything go out of whack?
Most of my patients who come to me for testosterone treatment, because I'm a urologist, so they tend to come to because of the sexual function.
Right.
So I do have patients who have been on testosterone for a while, then they say, Doc, should I just stop the medication? So a lot of them, after stopping, they find that the reason why they came to see me in the first place, those symptoms actually came back. So actually some of them come back and say that, oh, actually they find that they did benefit from it. and they will actually want to continue the medication.
So once I start testosterone treatment, it then becomes a lifelong treatment. Is that what we're saying?
It is a chronic treatment, yes, especially if your levels are really low. Because other than helping with the symptoms, like we mentioned earlier, now we know that it also helps with control of sugars. And the long run, low testosterone also results in osteoporosis in men. Cool. So it's also good for bone health.
Oh, wow.
Hey, but how do you know whether your patients are telling you the truth or not, Dr. Tan? Maybe they'll come, they'll say, oh, you know, doctor, I think, you know, I need it. You know,
but actually,
yeah.
Blood.
Yeah.
So, of course, we correlate the symptoms to the blood results. Yeah. Because let's say, for example, a patient comes in and says that he has a lot of sexual symptoms, he's worried about testosterone, and we check and we find the testosterone level is actually normal. Usually, I will just explain to the patient that you can't blame your symptoms on testosterone itself. Mm-hmm. Then we have to further investigate whether see what are the other problems that are actually causing him to have these symptoms.
I see.
Okay, got it.
We are talking to Dr. Ronnie Tan, urologist from Mount Elizabeth and Parkway East Hospitals. You know, if you've always suspected that, you know, something might be wrong in this area, you know, do go and see Dr. Tan. Mm-hmm. Dr. Tan, you're open every day?
Yeah, except Sundays.
He needs a break too. Dr. Tan, do you have any other parting words for diabetic men, specifically with testosterone deficiency?
Okay, so I think for these diabetic men, should they have some sexual symptoms, do not just blame it on diabetes alone, because you know diabetes carries a high risk of patient having erectile dysfunction at an early date. If they are concerned, they should get their testosterone level checked. And then together, by treating the sugars and raising the hormonal levels to normal, they will be able to have a better lifestyle. And also, it helps to improve their bone health and, in their general well-being.
Okay. Fantastic. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Tan, for joining us this morning. It's been a pleasure, and we certainly hope to talk to you again real soon.
Sure.
Thanks so much, Dr. Tan. Bye. Have a great day.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Tan. Thanks.
Bye.
We know who to look for.
Yeah.
We start experiencing.
Interesting stuff, though.
No, I already feel like I think I'm growing boobs.
Are you growing man boobs?
So maybe I need to see, you know.
Less estrogen, more testosterone.
You see, but that's also because of what we were talking about earlier on, you know, our diet and all that. You know, I think we've been eating so much.
It's true.
I think I want to switch to a plant-based diet.
It's interesting because, Angel, you got to understand, this is the team you're looking at.
Yeah.
You're working with now. He has man boobs and I look pregnant. So, yeah. That's the team you got.
But a shocking fact about Singapore is that we are the highest in the world for lifestyle-related diabetes.
Yes.
You know which is why even our Prime Minister came up. I think a few weeks ago it was World Diabetes Day or something like that.
Yes.
And he came up with a message,
yes.
You know, to tell us to all, you know, live a healthier lifestyle.
Yes.
And you know, be very careful because the numbers are increasing. And, you know, Dr. Tan mentioned earlier on, in 2014, we had close to 500,000 people here in Singapore affected by diabetes. Can you imagine now?
That was 7 years ago, and he says it's going up because of more affluence, the type of food and everything else.
And the message I want to put out there is we're talking about adults.
Yeah.
Please remember that all these things, the lifestyle, the food.
Includes the children.
It's the kids.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Okay.
It gets the kids.
Traffic man.
Yes, sirree, Bob.
He's outside, so I'm just waiting for him to come in.
Stand by.
Okay.
Oh, Gurmit's outside, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, no problem. You can walk in anytime. No problem.
This way.
I can just ask him to come in.
Tell him to come in.
1.3 traffic.
Alrighty, let's take a look at the traffic situation. The KJE towards the BKE. Vehicle broken down after the PIE entrance. PIE towards Changi. An accident before Tampany Street 31. Avoid lane 3. Yutong Sen Street towards Park Crescent. Roadworks after Newbridge Road. Avoid the left lane. The rest of it's basically just usual delays across the expressway, so it's not going to surprise you too much. Stay within the speed limit, good people. Make sure you have everyone buckled up. Be safe as you drive today.
Good morning, Singapore. Welcome to our world. It's a big world. It's the big show. Gurmit Singh is in the building. I think he's in the waiting area.
We've lost him.
I have a feeling the speakers are on. They might be tuned into us. Paging for Gurmit Singh. Paging for Gurmit Singh.
Paging.
Please come to the studio.
Come.
Push. It's a push door.
Come.
We are live on Facebook.
It says on air. We are on air.
On air.
Are you on air? I thought
we
did.
Hey, how are you? Have a seat. Oh, everyone's in the house.
Okay, yeah,
sit up. That's your seat.
Ah, yes, on air now, please. Thank you very much.
Yes, yes, we're all on air.
Please have a seat. We are live. We are live right now. We are live on Facebook.
We're live on air and on Facebook. So say good morning, Gurmit.
Good morning, Gurmit.
Where's my headphones?
Right
in front of me.
Is that them?
Is it there?
It's a very small headphone because I can't see it.
Okay, let's get it.
Okay, never mind.
But it's okay. Anyway. It's actually last day is here today anyway, so.
Oh. Well, by the way, what is she? Is she an intern or
she's
what?
Our producer. She's
oh, because we asked her, are you intern? She said, no, I'm sort of a producer.
She is.
She is a confidence sort of producer. She's our God-sending saving gift.
As she just said, there's no definition. There's no definition.
Everything that we don't know how to do, Anjali does for us.
Okay.
There's just a lot.
Yeah. I have this rash here. I don't know what to do.
That's not what she does, Gurmit.
She just said anything.
Yeah, not rashes.
She's okay. She's only 20. Stop
Gums,
it.
Let us see your handsome face. Yes. Take off your mask.
Oh, yeah, of course. I'm so used to this.
We set it up so nicely here, social distancing and all that. Ladies and gentlemen, please give Gurmit Singh a big round of applause. Good to have you on the show this morning.
Yeah. Well, thank you for having me, man. Long time no see you guys.
Yeah. I know.
My goodness.
How have you been?
I've been like everybody else. We've been trying to avoid COVID.
Yes,
haven't we? Oh my goodness, what a piece of...
Yes, yeah. We can say it later on Facebook, but not on air.
Not on air.
Oh, we're on air now, is it?
Yes, we're on air.
Yes, we are on air. Let's get straight into it. You're here today because we're talking about A Dose of Comedy 2, which is happening from the 6th to the 8th of May at the Drama Centre.
That's right.
It is A Dose of Comedy 2 because A Dose of Comedy 1 happened and it was a big hit.
It was. I mean, Kumar, come on.
Yeah, it was sold out.
Me and Kumar, you mean together?
Comparable.
Comedic
Kumar,
legends.
Okay, tell you what, Kumar is my ex-girlfriend. So I just want to say that we are no more longer together.
But why?
Why? No, because, you know, she sleeps late. I had to get up early.
So,
there's someone here.
She's
at
happy.
So about that rash.
That's terrible. Okay, behave.
What is terrible about rash? It is terrible. Rash is very terrible.
You know what's the awesome thing right now?
Gums
is in the studio, right? And people are watching him.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Because it could have just been an audio thing today, you know.
Oh, I appreciate
it. But we are both on the radio as well as on the bigshow.tv. So we're very happy to have you with us this morning, Gurmit.
Oh, happy to be here. I got to say though, when you guys tagged me on my social media, I said, oh, "My goodness, Big Show." Big Show, the wrestler. I don't follow him, but
I know. We're trying to work out the SEOs on that.
Right. But I'm so happy to be here because, you know, it's the first time I'm stepping into SBH.
Oh,
to be fair,
okay.
To be honest, because you know, last time a competitor.
That's true. You know, sometimes we do try and get you know, some of the MediaCorp people to come over here as guests, but unfortunately, I think that there are rules.
We cannot go
over to the competitors. I'm like, but why? SG United, folks.
It's true.
You know, I mean, it's us. Guests feel comfortable with us. We always look after our guests. But anyway, back to A Dose of Comedy. Tell us a little bit more about that, Gurmit.
It's a comedy show.
Oh, wow. We wouldn't have known.
Really?
You alone?
Look, I know Glenn and FD very well. And sometimes things just go over their heads. So I must establish the base first before they... otherwise, at the end of the show, they're like, hey, what are you coming for? there are a few of us, not just me. There are a few comedians. And I'm so happy to be part of this because I don't often do stand-up.
Yeah, you don't.
I don't. Because I think that is, for me, the ultimate challenge.
It's the hardest thing in the world.
Ooh, dude, it's like going on stage to say, hey guys, how are you? I'm going to be funny. Yeah. Well, what if you're not?
Yeah.
And you can't tell. Whereas when you're acting as Phua Chu Kang in a studio set, right, you hash it and you hash it and you hash it, you rehearse, you rehearse, mm-hmm. and then after a while you get the flow, and then the episodes will start to roll out
right.
funny, right? Because you know what works and what doesn't work. And I have to tell you this, even when doing Phua Chu Kang, right, when I was sitting doing in the studio, some lines I thought would be damn funny wasn't funny. Some lines I didn't even think was funny, it was just a statement. People laughed in the studio. And like, don't know what happened. But so that's comedy for you. You never know.
Right. Mm.
So it's a big fear. I know people have asked me to do it, and I have refused.
You refused?
I have refused.
It
scares the living hell out of me.
Why? You're such a serious guy. You should do comedy.
Yeah, that's the thing. I don't know why people think I can do this.
No, but you would be a deadpan kind of guy.
Yeah.
Doing comedy.
Yeah.
I think if I got up with these ears, they'd just laugh naturally.
It's physical comedy.
No, actually, I've worked with FD for so many years.
Yes.
And I'm always very honest with him.
Yeah.
You cannot do stand-up.
I can't do stand-up.
No. FD cannot do stand-up. He can do mime. He can be a Marcel Marceau.
Marcel Marceau.
With a little bit of training, I think you'll be excellent.
Oh, no. So, you know, folks, we've been on 1FM 91.3 for a few years now, and Glenn has finally publicly told me to shut up.
Don't say that, la. Stand-up comedy is a different monster altogether.
Yes, yes.
We are with Gurmit Singh. The one and only Gurmit Singh right here on The Big Show. We continue with the music. Here's In Excess, Need You Tonight. 1FM 91.3. Good times, greatest hits. Good morning. All right.
But you know, when it comes to comedy, I feel that comedians are the best talent in the world, because comedians can do serious acting, but serious actors can't always do comedy.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You know,
for
so
sure.
Once you hit comedy, you are set.
Mm.
So I don't know why you're so worried.
I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm all set. All set. What am I doing here? Wasting my time. I'm all set.
And my serious actors get
you're
paid
set,
more.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, it's true what you say, because it takes, you know, I've been asked also by producers or schools to do comedy workshops.
Mm.
And I said no. I've been asked by universities to do a class, what do you call it?
A module.
Yeah, see, I don't know how to do module.
Okay,
because
okay.
I A-level only.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
So I said, I cannot do that. I said, why? You're very funny. I can impart some of your knowledge. I said, no, I have no syllabus.
Mm. Yeah.
I can't say lesson one will do this, lesson two.
True.
Secondly, I am strongly of the opinion that people need the exact timing to be a comedian.
Yes. Mm.
We did PCK the musical in the theater, and then the producer got his friend to do, you know, some of the parts, and that guy had some of the good best lines in the musical, but he couldn't deliver it.
Oh. Mm.
He couldn't. Yeah. He even faced the wrong. He faced the back instead of facing the. That's what I knew. Something's wrong. This guy is not an actor.
Direction is not on
him. Don't ever. No. He stood up and then turned back and said the line. And I'm like, what is he saying to?
For our Facebook viewers, everybody's asking who the two photo bombers are at the back. There's Gurmit's bodyguards.
Sorry, photo bombers.
Yeah, I'd like you to meet my first wife, Lakshmi.
But,
wife, Sunoy.
Introduce them, Gurmit.
Yeah, come.
Come, say hello.
Hello.
Hi, Sean here.
Sean.
I'm Bernard.
Oh, we got Sean and Vernon.
They are the organizers.
Yes, they are.
Yeah.
Generation X.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. So they call me up.
Yeah. Why did you guys start you know, these productions again?
Come over to the microphone.
Come on over. Come on over.
Yeah, kind of. Whole of last year was a write off, so we decided why not, since they eased up on the restrictions and allowed shows to start again. So we decided, why not? Let's start off with stand-up comedy, because it's the easiest show to produce. I've been doing it for 20 years. That's why it's easiest for me. Yeah. And we also wanted to give the people in the theatre a job.
So they've been
sitting around doing nothing for one whole year.
Good on you guys.
So that's what we wanted to do. Feed them as well, right?
Yeah. Good. And the response is very good after the first dose of comedy.
Yes. So this second dose will complete you.
I mean, with what we're going through right now, the thing we really need is comedy.
Yeah,
because you cannot be in a corner moping and moaning. Moaning? No.
Yeah, you can moan, people moan.
I've moaned in a corner a couple of times in my life.
FD.
I wasn't always alone.
Must be, you know.
That's why I like
FD.
Was it after midnight?
So I say all those people who actually had the first dose of comedy must get the second dose in order for it to be effective.
Nice one. This is vaccination comedy.
But they may get more side effects. Which is laughter.
This is true. This is true.
Laughter,
guys,
is the best medicine.
An ache,
right?
It is. An ache in your tummy, perhaps, from laughing too much.
Yeah. And then your cheekbones will be so highlighted. You know, the
blush. You don't need blush. Blush. Yeah. Natural rouge. Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
So tell us a little bit more about A Dose of Comedy too.
Who else is there?
Who else is there?
There's
you.
So there's Derek. Derek. Deepak. Ministry of Funny. And who else?
Orion.
Orion Perez. Yes.
Orion's a great.
Orion Perez.
Yeah, he's a really interesting comedian where he does accents.
Okay.
Yeah, so I can't do accents. Can you do accents, you guys?
Not really. He can do accents.
Can do accents.
Oh, okay.
Mark
the
can do accents.
The easy one is to do French.
This is very difficult to do.
But then how do you do a Scottish accent?
Ah, you see, you got to make sure that it's a great day. If you don't have a great day, there's nothing you can do.
There, you see, yeah. I always say, I always maintain the Scottish accent is the same as the Indian accent.
Same.
Who said that, right?
Yes.
No, you must talk to Glenn.
Glenn,
no, Scottish, la. Indian, Italian, French, all sound the same.
Same, same, all me too. Bro, I always try to start off with a German or Scottish accent, I'll end up with the Indian accent. We have ways of making you talk, and after that we will tell you how to do it. I cannot sustain. So I have great respect for people who can do and sustain accents. It's amazing.
Ryan is good. Honestly, one of the best accent people I have ever heard is Chris Pine.
Oh really?
Oh really?
Wow.
Chris Pine can listen to a person for 2 minutes and then completely mimic the person.
You know him personally? Like
no, I've seen videos of him do this.
Right.
He just listens to someone for 2 minutes and then bam, he's got the accent down.
Nice.
He's so talented.
Chris Pine.
Chris Pine.
Benedict Cumberbatch also.
Wait, Benedict Cumberbatch.
Did you say
Chris
Cumberbatch?
Pine or Chris Pratt?
Pine is Star Trek. Pratt is
I think Pratt's
no,
the one.
Pratt, sorry.
All of us are so short.
Wow.
Yeah, I know, it doesn't act like...
No, Pratt is different. Pratt. Comedy
sorry,
actor,
my mistake.
Yeah.
Beam me up, Scotty! Yeah.
Can
He's
you imagine?
Guardian of the galaxy. Hey.
Beam me up, Scotty! Hey. The roti is waiting!
Hey, it won't be Scotty, no. It won't be Scotty anyway. Beam me up, Suresh!
Come on, Ade! Che! Vanda!
Oh my goodness.
So while we're still live on the bigshow.tv and not, you know, on the radio, we're going to ask you some other questions when we get back on the radio.
Yeah.
You know, of course, most Singaporeans know you best for Phua Chu Kang.
Yeah.
You did it for so many years. You still do Phua Chu Kang.
I'm still doing
it. Cannot run.
I think I just saw you on Shopee, right?
Shopee. Yeah. And then, of course, for the garment, I did the rap for COVID.
Yes.
In fact, I just finished the second rep.
Oh.
That's the second rep coming up.
Oh, yeah?
Here's something I've always wanted to ask people who have spent so much time in a character. Does it haunt you? Are there moments when you just want to get
away? See a wig and run away?
I know people who are like who feel that way, but I don't because we are so worlds apart. I mean, we share certain similarities in that we love our family, we'll protect our family, we'll go through the alongs to protect our family. Yeah. But besides, other than that, nothing else. So when I take off the wig and the boots and the mole, I'm done. I finish.
Okay.
You know. Although I can put him anytime I want na, because I want to talk like him. I also can na. But after that, huh, I don't talk like him. I also can. Also, like Gurmit Singh can talk like himself. Huh? Don't mind. Not say on say.
Then I will just come back to where I am.
So the boots are not part of your daily wardrobe then?
No. Today
you wear other boots. Okay.
It's not yellow.
Cannot see.
Brown boots.
Yeah. Brown boots.
But you know, a reporter asked me once. You know, so how is it like to be off season? I said I'm not off. I'm still doing Phua Chu Kang. I still go to before COVID. I still go to Malaysia and do.
Okay, hold on,
Gums.
Yes, you're going for a traffic update.
All right, okay.
FD, you're on.
All right, FD.
FM 91.3 traffic.
We've got the usual delays across the expressways. That
really?
Shouldn't, yes, it's true. That shouldn't surprise you too much this morning. Shut up, Gavin.
At the office, Mike. No?
Switch him off.
The PIE towards Changi, an accident before Tampines Street 31. Avoid lane 3. That's about it. Yutong Sen Street, for days we've had those roadworks. This is just after New Bridge Road. Just stay within the speed limit, folks. Make sure you've got everyone buckled up. Drive safely.
Everyone.
You're on the Big Show TV as well as 1FM 91.3. We are the Big Show. Glenn Angel, FD, Sean, and today our special guest, of course, Gurmit Singh. Thank you so much, Gurm, for being with us.
Pleasure.
Always nice seeing you, catching up with you, and we're so very excited about this new show that you're going to be a part of, A Dose of Comedy 2, to be held at the Drama Centre from the 6th to the 8th of May. Tell us a little bit more. You mentioned earlier on you're not going to be alone. Who else will be on the show with you?
We have Ministry of Fun, which is the entire ministry. There's the government coming out.
Wow.
They're a lot more fun these days, speaking of the government.
Yeah, it's true.
It's true, right?
So I think the next one, maybe the organizers should get Ministry of Health. And then
that could be fun.
Hey, Gums, let me tell you who's cool.
Who's cool?
Ong Ye Kung is cool.
Ong Ye Kung. Yes.
And next week, in your hot seat, will be Mr. Ong Ye Kung.
Oh, let me just fart then.
Let the present.
Gurmit. Hey, it's a natural phenomenon, okay? If we don't let it go, you have to let it go. Like the song, let it go, let it go, let it go.
I don't know how much of a phenomenon it is, but.
Okay, so Ministry of Fun.
Ministry of Fun, we have Deepak. And then with this new guy, what's his name? The accent guy.
Orion Perez.
It's so funny because I was looking at this sheet and without my reading glasses, I thought it said onion.
Well, sometimes he feels like that too.
Orion makes you cry
with his jokes.
Oh, really? Is he that good?
Laugh, okay. Cry. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. So tickets are still available, obviously. I mean, there's $75, but there's an early bird discount. Are you serious?
No, not serious, of course. Can you imagine I come to the show and say, there's only one left now?
How long is this show, though?
As a show.
As a show?
What? 90 minutes?
90 minutes. You don't even know.
I'm just focusing on my bit, that's all. I'm going to turn up and do my bit. I don't even know whether I'm the first or the second or the last guy. But once they push me on stage, I'm going to do my bit and then run off.
Oh, so you're all going to be doing it individually, as individual acts?
Like a stand-up show?
Just going around,
we can't do it. I don't know whether you've been to stand-up shows. We cannot do stand-up all at the same time.
I've only been to his.
It's very hard to hear the jokes.
That's why.
Five comedians saying all the jokes at one time. Hey, I can't get the joke.
It'll be like this show.
Somebody slap him for
well
me.
Done, Sean. Well done. Hey, comedian next time get Sean. Sean is a stand-up comedian.
He
is.
I've been doing this for 5 years, man.
Multi-talented producer, no?
As in this job for 5 years.
No, stand-up.
Hey, there you go.
This is about 11 years.
Okay, comedy, those three.
Those three.
Sean, tell them, tell the organizers here who you've opened up shows with.
Wow.
Or four.
Yeah. I've done Kumar, so I've opened
You've
for
done
Kumar.
Kumar.
I've
done Kumar.
You've done Kumar. Kumar. This is why Kumar's not smiling so much now. So
once he connects the Sean,
Big tasty, baby.
It was a Shawshank Redemption.
Exactly. I've done stand up in Melbourne, Sydney, New York, Amsterdam. Here, Telok Ayer, Tras Street.
He's been everywhere.
Very far, I cannot get there.
Sean has been around.
Get Sean to perform for y'all one of these days.
Oh, good. I love this. So, what about you others? Do you want to do stand-up comedy?
No, man. I can't.
An angel?
No, absolutely. I'm not funny. I really am not.
That in itself is a funny line. You go and say, hi, everybody. I'm not funny.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Before we go back live on the Big Show TV, I just want to ask you, Gums, where can people get the tickets from?
Ah, well, thank you very much for asking that question. ComedyDose2.ptix.com.
Oh, PTIX.
PTIX.
It's on PTIX.com. What mic is that?
That's
an Irishman after too much whiskey.
That's a Gurmit Singh accent. All right, up next, Gwen Stefani featuring Akon. Here's The Sweet Escape on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. We're with Gurmit Singh, live on TheBigShow.tv.
We're getting some very funny comments on our Facebook page. I know what they're trying to say. They want to see you and Kumar together on stage, but they're saying, I'd like to see Kumar do it with Gurmit.
Careful now, we got children watching.
May I suggest that happens in Dose of Comedy 3?
I think so.
With Big Tasty or something.
I'll need a king size bed. Just we'll put on the specs right now.
How is Kumar, by the way? I mean, I'm sure you've met up with him recently.
You know, all of us in the industry, I tell you, after I left the station, I went to freelancing and all that. I found newfound respect for freelancers, because when this COVID came, my entire calendar
was wiped out.
Yeah.
Yes. Email after email after email came in saying cancer. And
yeah.
I told my family, okay, time to eat grass. Everybody go to the garden now.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
And all of us suffered. All of us felt it. And, you know, sitting with Kuma, I was doing We Are Singaporeans TV show. And we were a bunch of comedians there with Fakafas and all that. And we were thinking, wow, this is really, we are really, you know, hit badly. But we got to pivot, we got to make do with whatever we do. So we went hybrid, we went virtual, we went that. And, you know, suddenly we're investing in webcams, we're investing in ring lights, things like that. Yeah. I'm very happy on behalf of all the freelancers that the things are opening up now. And for people like, you know, these guys who organize this comedy show, it's not just for, let's do a show and make some money. It's also for us to have a job, to get some money, to allow the theater, the stage people to get some money as well. Not much, but still something to get by, you know.
Yeah.
And I think that's very important. And of course, to give comedy and some relief to the people who are cooped up and finding all this a bit overwhelming and come and just laugh for a bit.
Hey, it's been tough. I mean, I've had friends in this industry who were very successful DJs who are now social distancing ambassadors. But it's good that that there are opportunities at least for them to still earn money. But for so many of the talent out there wasn't that opportunity.
Right, right.
And it was really, really hard.
Yeah.
But it's coming back. It's coming back.
It's gonna come back. It's gonna.
Can you imagine? I mean, at least for us, we have our radio, our radio show.
Yeah.
Because all of us used to host as well as host outside, right?
Yeah.
Host on the radio as well as, you know, do gigs outside. And we've got some friends who do it professionally, just hosting gigs, professional MCs.
Yeah.
Oh, they were so affected, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Very bad.
You're talking to one of them now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even TV, because TV also completely stopped.
Yeah. Right. And
so tough.
I find it very... this is kind of ironic, though, because when we started opening up this shows via Zoom and what have you, right? So many of the event companies have turned around and turned their office into a studio.
Studio,
right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then there are a few cameras there. So I was doing an event there, a few cameras, and then the auto cue and everything all there. And I'm talking to the camera, to the people who are at home and in the offices and all. The clients were in the studio as well. This was like a anniversary, a dinner and dance kind of thing, but no dinner and no dance. And then after the whole thing was over, they said, thank you very much, Gurmit. The clients and the event company said, no, you did a great job. And we're so sorry that you had to do it in this kind of environment. And I said, no, hang on. You don't understand this. This was exactly what I was doing in TV.
That's true.
Right?
Actually, the cross to virtual and hybrid would have been so much easier for you than, say, for Glenn or myself.
So I
That's right.
So but even we felt like it was easier.
Yeah.
You know, frankly speaking, right? Doing it virtually, hosting it virtually. Yeah. I mean, for me, I felt it was easier than being on the stage.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, for some people, they love it. Like, he loves being on the stage.
But
I just host for the money. I always say this. It's not like I enjoy hosting. I just do it for the money. You know what I mean?
But different people pull off different things. Because like you, myself as well, we feed off the audience.
Yeah. Yes.
And you, exactly. You know, you need that energy to be able to project that energy. Mm. You do it for the money, so you don't really care. Yeah. But
I'm professional like that.
He could be in the wrong ballroom and still do that.
I'm sure a lot of people are curious, how did you keep yourself busy during Circuit Breaker? Like, what did you and the family get up to? Did you guys suddenly become bakers? Did your wife perfect the sourdough or muffins or whatever it was, and the kids?
Well, a lot of people I knew did baking and all that, but we also did a lot of social media. So I roped in my son and my daughter to help me produce sketches for my Instagram and all that. And then we got really serious, like green screen and then, you know, we had separate different cameras. And then because I have a 24-year-old, a 20-year-old and an 8-year-old, so the 8-year-old came
in
and
said, wait, your eldest is what? Your eldest is 20 what?
Four.
Four.
No.
Wow.
My cousin.
Hey, FD, what you talking about?
Wait.
Bale. How old are you? 56.
And you have a 24-year-old.
Wow.
What does it mean?
Wow. He's trying to do the math now.
That's okay, what?
I married when I was 5. I don't know my math. Yeah, so 24, 20. So then the little one, 8 years old, she saw what was happening, right? Then, no, because we'll say, okay, stand by and action. And then she said, I also want to do.
So cute.
So she did. She would say, and action! And then while I'm doing halfway, she said, Daddy, could you? I said, no, I'm doing my work. You cannot say anything. And there was one little bit with sketch we did where I was asking people to hydrate. So the sketch would be that when I'm brushing teeth, suddenly the water splashes from the side. Yeah. If I'm taking off my clothes, another water, splash water and all that. And then she was in charge of one of them, right? She has a glass ready. So I said, okay, when I do this, then you splash. Then she splashed. I said, oh, okay, good. And then she splashed again. And then she splashed.
She couldn't stop.
She couldn't stop. I said, enough.
And she's still splashing you till today.
Yeah. Yes, she's a mermaid now.
So she's eight, right?
She's eight, primary
and
two.
Any one of them taking after you with entertainment or being in front of the camera during like Circuit Breaker, did any one of them appear in your videos?
No, they are camera shy kind of thing. But they did, they do want to go in that path, I guess. And this is not because I asked them to. I think it's in the blood kind of thing. Mm-hmm. My son is doing special effects.
Oh, nice.
So things that you do behind scene, post-production, all those. You know. And then my elders is doing a mixed degree with a fine arts and theatre.
Oh, wow.
Okay. She's from School of the Arts as well. So she did film and TV studies. And then my little one wants to be a unicorn.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, but come on, all 8-year olds want to be a unicorn.
I wanted to, but then my horn didn't grow. Wait.
Oops. Well, good thing we're on Facebook. Okay.
But does your daughter enjoy acting? I mean, she's doing theatre, but it doesn't necessarily mean that she's going to be an actress, right?
She does. Which one, the eldest or the youngest?
Eldest.
Your eldest, right? Your eldest is doing theatre studies?
She prefers theatre to TV or film. She likes that. Organic, I guess.
Has she been in any production?
Oh yeah, many.
Oh really?
She's smart. She's a smart girl.
And she's the one who has a voice, isn't she? Isn't she the one that wrote an article about some music that was playing in a store?
Yes, she did.
I thought that was so brave and so wonderful of her to do.
When she was 13 years old, she already published 2 self-published books.
Oh, wow.
Poetry and a book. When she was 12 years old, she wrote into the papers.
When she was how old?
12.
12, wow. Right.
Because she, in the forum page, she wrote to the forum page because a reporter was really putting me down.
Putting you down,
criticizing me and all that kind of thing. But he crossed the line because he talked about PCK and how it's such a... And then started talking about how lousy I am as a dad and all that. So we get personal, you know?
Wow, okay.
She couldn't take it. She didn't tell anybody. She went online and she wrote a letter saying that you can, if you don't like it, it's fine with you. But then you have no right to go personal on
to get so personal.
And she's only 12 years old.
At 12, she did that. Yeah. Wow.
Well done.
Stand by, we're going back on air again, huh?
Okay. That's my air.
3, 2.
The cars would drive right here on the big show. The big show. OneFM 91.3.
Bye-bye, cars.
Our special guest for this morning is the one and only Gurmit Singh. Thank you so much, Gurmit, for being with us today.
Thank you for being here.
Thanks for the sound effects.
We were talking about like juicy stuff live on the bigshow.tv. So, you know, if you missed it, if you're just listening to us exclusively right now, you can always watch it anytime during the day on our Facebook pages, the OneFM 91.3 Facebook page, as well as the bigshow.tv Facebook page.
Yeah, we were talking about Gurmit's horn that never grew.
We were getting personal.
Right? We were getting real personal.
You know, I like to share. Sharing is caring, guys.
Yes.
Oh, can I just say that today there's a promo code going on.
Okay.
Today is a discount. Yeah, for the tickets for the show. Not for my horn.
We weren't talking about your horn. Let's clarify.
Yes. For those of you just joining us, we're talking about A Dose of Comedy 2, which will be held at the Drama Centre from the 6th to the 8th of May, starring Gurmit Singh.
And a few others as well, Mystery of Fun and so on. If you do the early bird draw, you pay, of course, you have a discount. But then if you do today, there's a promo code. The promo code is 1FM.
Okay.
And then instead of paying 75, you pay only 60.
Wow.
Ka-ching.
For it, guys.
That's not too bad, huh?
That's a good deal.
Yeah. And you can get your tickets at adoseofcomedy2.ptix.com. Also, a big shout out to Derek, who's the food and beverage sponsor for the entire event.
Ooh.
From the Tipsy Collective.
Ah.
These guys are great. Oh, yeah. I've been
thanks,
there performing at their places a few times as well.
Gurmit's like, at least I'll be fed.
Yeah, I know. I always assume the worst, so that then your bar is very low. There is potato chips.
I mean, how many times have you hosted an event and you don't get fed dinner?
Oh, all the time. But, but the thing is this, I don't like to eat before I host a dinner and dance.
Okay. Oh my God.
Because I get too comfortable and sleep on stage, right?
Yeah.
So only after the event is over, then
same here, man. Yeah. I can't eat during, before, during.
During?
I can't.
And now the lucky number.
I can't.
It's not, and I'm going to get CO now to say a few. Is there anything in my teeth? Say a few words.
Yeah, I'm sure there are some people who will actually do that. I mean, come on. FD, I know you.
I think I'm going to do that one day.
I've seen a lot in my time.
Right.
FD can host while he's eating. He can host while he's sleeping. He's such a pro.
No, I've seen MCs on stage with a whiskey water in their hand.
No, really?
Oh. Don't make it seem like it's a bad thing.
It is a bad thing.
It's a little unprofessional, but it's still okay.
You can have your drink off stage. Unless there's a toast.
It's a toast. And it's given to you by somebody who's giving out drinks. Yes. Yeah.
Maybe it's like a style thing. Remember George Burns, the comedian?
He goes
up with a cigar for the entire show.
So okay, other than yourself, who's as funny as George Burns in Singapore? Nobody. So you don't have the right to carry the whiskey on stage.
So I can hold my cigar then.
Oh, of course you can.
We should not cram anyone's style.
True. I agree.
We should not cram anyone's style.
No.
But I mean, look, FD is serious about this because this is part of your module, right?
Yeah, it is.
You've got, this guy conducts courses like MC courses, DJ courses.
Before COVID hit, I had an academy. We've shut it now because of COVID. We can't do it.
Okay.
And we had an alumni. And one of the rules of the alumni is if you were ever caught drunk, you were kicked out of the alumni.
Oh, right. Of course.
Wow.
Because you see, as MCs, we carry the industry on our shoulder 24/7.
Yes.
Mm. And we have to maintain the image. Otherwise, people just think we're a bunch of idiots.
Yes. Mm. Yes.
So I am very passionate about that. I'm very passionate.
Good on you. Well,
I hate it that FD is doing this because he's putting out more MCs out there.
You know what I mean? True, so
which means less jobs for us.
Yeah.
Stop it, FD.
Stop it. All the MCs get drunk.
Hey.
Touch a lot of money.
Just don't undercut us. I'll kill y'all.
Right.
Don't touch a lot of money.
We continue with the music right now. Here's Enigma, Return to Innocence, right here on 1FM's Big Show. Good morning. We're with Gurmit Singh.
Yay.
Okay, so Gurmit, first time doing stand-up comedy?
Not first time. This will be my third, I believe.
Are you doing it as Gurmit?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, because I can do it as Kuma.
But you're not doing it as PCK, I guess that's the question most people are asking. Right?
No. If I wanted to, then I could, but I have to go through MediaCorp because the IP belongs to them.
I was going to ask, can you be him anytime? You can't, right?
I can. But whenever I get a request via email, say, oh, my company has this and this, I need PCK, and then I just
connect them
to the managers at the station. Yeah. Mm.
Right,
but I'm doing it as myself. Yeah. The first time I did it was Happy Ever Laughter.
Yes.
That was at the
Marina Bay Sands.
The
one I saw you at was Resorts World. You did your security guard.
Oh, okay. That wasn't a stand-up thing. That was me hosting as a security guard.
Yes,
right? And then the second time I did was for Haris Iskandar in KL.
Okay.
Joke Factory. I went there and did that.
Joke Factory, that's good.
Haris, my God,
Haris. How is Haris?
He's hilarious.
How is he?
I think he's losing weight, no?
Really?
Yeah.
He was on our show when he was in Singapore years ago. Very nice guy. Married to a gorgeous lady who's a doctor, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, she is.
Yeah. See, I only remember that.
Married to the doctor. No, the doctor he remembers.
No, he's like Harris. Who? What does he look like again?
I'm like, really? That's your wife?
What happened?
But what a guy. A fantastic man.
You know? I like to call him a intelligent comedian.
Mm.
Because we did PCK Sendran Berhad. And he was supposed to be PCK's business partner in Malaysia.
Oh, okay.
And he would sit down and look at the script. And then he'll come to me and say, bro, this one I think got a problem. I say, why? Then you point out something and I say, oh yeah, shit, you're right. I mean, yes, feces.
It's fine.
So I said, oh yeah, that's true. Let's bring it up to the director and producer and then we'll talk about it. And then sometimes you come in and say, bro, I think I want to do this because then I thought the next scene we can go. I say, cool, bro, let's do it. You know, so I really appreciate that because you don't just come up, show up and do it for the money.
Glenn on. So if he's an intelligent comedian, what are you? What kind of comedian are you?
I'm a physical comedian. I love my Jim Carrey, Robin Williams, Jerry Lewis. Those are my mentors. My goodness, they're so funny.
I still remember today, I watched Ace Ventura 5 times. Mm. And one of my favorite scenes, and a lot of things he does is ad-lib, right?
Yeah.
He was coming into, his character was coming into this apartment, and then his landlord was behind him, and the landlord with the husky voice says, "Ace Ventura's." And then he said, "Yes, Satan." This, but yeah, so...
One of my favorite Jim Carrey movies is Liar Liar.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, his facial expressions, it looks like... Yeah. Yeah, genius.
Yes, right? he is.
And Jerry Lewis also. Let's not forget.
Oh yeah,
Rubber Face.
And he teamed up with Dean Martin. Yeah. And by the way, Jerry Lewis was a great drummer.
Oh, was he? Yeah.
He was really? A prolific drummer. He just didn't show it on his variety show. He'll play a bit of that, but other than that, he'll do a lot of comedy and all that.
Mm. Yeah.
When he used to love telephones. Watching all the black and white movies.
Oh yeah,
Jerry Lewis and Dean Martin.
Yeah, those so are good. Great movies. When you do a comedy show like that, I mean, how much of the show is dependent on the reaction of the audience?
A lot. That's why I say stand-up is very, very, very challenging.
So do you improv?
You have to. Because the better ones I know will improv and try to tailor to what he's feeling from the audience, you know. And some of them were the more professional ones, say, "Oh, tough crowd. Just say it out loud." Or say, "Oh, you didn't get that? Okay, later on you'll get it when you go home."
Kind of. Yeah.
And that's why I say it's very hard. And those who are not really into this or not professional or enough experience, they would just say their lines for the sake of saying their lines and hope somebody's funny. But the rest of us will try to really, you know, dig up. And it's hard because, first of all, because of the seating arrangement, they are at the biggest group will be 8 per group, right? So they're sparsely... seated, and that's a real challenge for us. A lot of people don't realize this, but when the place is nice and packed, people find it easier to laugh.
Yeah, right.
There's less inhibition. Yeah. But when there's space, people are like, "Oh, if I laugh, people can hear me across the table." They're loony or something, right? So, Sean, you can attest to that, isn't it?
Yes, very much so. A lot of times in the shows that we do, the people don't really laugh out loud. But after the show, they come and tell you, "Bro, you're so funny, so good.
But funny and laugh,
right?" Yeah. Well, I found this lesson many, many years ago when I was first starting out in the business, This is 35 years ago. And I did a D&D and all that. And the whole ballroom, the entire night...
Quiet.
And then the applause was...
It was
a government thing,
Singapore is a tough crowd, though.
So I finished the show, right? And then the committee came and said, "Oh, the minister and the committee and the people are very happy." I said, "Really? Why?" "Oh, because the minister here cannot laugh out loud." So we even had events where, you know, the minister comes and we all very, you know, somber. Then the minister leaves at 10 o'clock and then I start a new program.
Yes.
Right?
Yes,
right.
Minister's gone. Now we can have fun.
Now we start. Then we say, "Okay, now we can start." And the whole board will go, "Yeah!"
Yeah.
No offense to
but
the
ministers. But actually, most of the time, right, it's not the ministers. No, it's the committees making that decision. Yeah. Because they're so afraid that, you know, people might get out of hand if you don't control it. And then, you know, something might happen and the minister might get offended, you know.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's the minister going like, "Okay, you please tell the MC."
No, they're not like that.
You can't do this or can't say that, you know. No. So organizing committees should chill out a little bit.
Talking about ministry, right, this reminds me of a story when I was starting out and I was hosting for Ministry of Environment.
Okay.
Long service awards as well included. So 20 years, 5 years, 10 years, whatever. Then every time there'll be a different department, like HR, finance, and then there was one department that would come up periodically for each category. That was the refuse department.
So the refuse.
Yeah. So I would make fun of the recipient and say, like, "Okay, this guy, when you go to him, can I?" "No, cannot!" He's a refuse department. And I added more jokes as the different category. Yeah. And then when I finished the event, I drove home in the car. Refuse!
Exactly. That's right. Rubbish!
It's the same spelling, right?
Yes, it is. It
so
is the same.
I'm so glad that I was a comedian. Because people were laughing. "Gabi, you're funny, Gabi." But I really thought it was refuse. And I thought, why would this company or this government
have a refuse department?
Just to say no.
Oh my goodness.
I want to complain about my... Oh, cannot.
Only comedians can get away with that. Oh my goodness.
Funny. Hey, before that, where's our Jang Jang?
He don't want to come in. He said, "Come in here, he's shy."
No,
come in now. We have our entertainer.
He's probably here.
Have someone coming in, playing the guitar and singing and all that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so he's probably here.
Come on. He's just outside, isn't he?
No, that's
Jang Jang!
His name is Jang Jang?
No.
His name is Johan, but his name is Jang Jang because he plays the guitar.
Oh.
So we call him Jang Jang Johan. He joins us on Wednesdays. Ah. And we sing songs.
Hey, Johan is watching. Johan, yes. Come in now.
Yeah, come on, man.
I've been texting him, come.
So meantime, you were saying, Gurmit, your mentor is Jerry Lewis,
Jim Carrey, and Robin Williams.
Where do you get your material from, though? I mean, what inspires your material? Is it your daily life? Is it your family? Is it life in general?
Jang Jang in the house.
He's starstruck.
Jang Jang.
Very shy. See?
If I could touch your body.
Wait.
Oh no.
Hey, we'll play something. Let Gurmit sing later.
Yeah.
By the way,
you said my whole name.
He brought the shaker.
Oh, the shaker is for you today.
Oh, it's my shaker.
No, Gurmit gets it.
Wow, you feel so hurt. No.
Let's talk
his instrument from him. I don't see no name on it. It says Minul. Are you Minul?
He's Minul.
It's my vitamin C.
He's a lower end shaker.
Yeah, you can have your drums as well if you want.
Yay!
Oh, what's happening here?
Wow. Percussion people.
So we've got to figure out what song we're singing.
Got me any requests? Or you prepare something?
Oh, you prepare something, is it?
Anybody wants
No, this is a jam session.
Let's do Faith.
Faith.
Oh, Faith.
Wow. You've
done it, right? Faith is good.
Yeah.
You can use,
do you have faith in doing Faith?
What do you call that mic?
Yeah, use FD's mic.
Yeah. Anybody want vitamin
Love
C?
Love this. No, thanks.
We cannot see you.
That's all powder already because he's been shaking it.
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
It would be nice.
Woo!
If I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you. But I gotta think twice before I give my heart away. And I know all the games to play because I play them too. Oh, but I need some time off from that emotion. Time to pick my heart up off the floor. Oh, when that love comes down with our devotion. Well, it makes a strong man, baby. But I'll open you the door, cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Because you gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. Baby, I know you're asking me to stay. I say please, please, please don't go away. Because I'm giving you the blues. Maybe. You mean every word you say. I can't help but think of yesterday. And another one who tied me down to a lover boy rose before this river becomes an ocean. Before you throw my heart back on the floor. Oh baby, I reconsider my foolish notion. When I need someone to hold me, but I'll wait for something more. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith.
Give me solo.
Woo!
Yeah.
What's up, what's solo?
We gotta have faith. I gotta have faith.
Yeah.
And thank
us.
Before this river becomes an ocean. Before you throw my heart back on the floor.
Yeah.
Oh baby, I reconsider my foolish notion. When I need someone to hold me, but I'll wait for something more. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Because you gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith.
Is happening on the 6th of May.
Okay. Gurmit, speaking of your world tour, we have requests for you to sing, please.
We just sang.
He just sang.
What do you mean?
None of us.
Oh.
No.
Oh.
No, that can't happen.
What?
Don't put him on the spot like that.
I don't mind singing.
Unless he wants.
Yeah, I want. Singing is my most favorite art form. I love
it. Really?
Right. What is my name? Gurmit?
Sing.
No, because the comment was, if you've got Jang Jang, it'd be so good to have a duet. Jang Jang and Gum Gum.
Let's do it then!
Jang, Jang, Jang.
Okay,
Okay, you all got to figure out a song. You all got to figure
yeah,
out.
Yeah,
a song.
Yeah, we will. We will.
You're the guest.
No, pick no, you please pick a song.
Oh, pick a song.
I believe I can fly.
Gurmit's like, that's I can sing anything.
No, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on
Endless
Big Show.
Endless Love, do it.
Let's do that. You be Diana.
Endless Love.
Endless Love.
Endless Love.
Oh my god, you have it.
If not, you have to do the Aladdin song.
Seriously, do you have it?
I can show you the world.
But Angel needs to do the ladies part. No.
Oh, me? Oh my god.
That's nice.
Because he's definitely going to do the Lionel Richie part. You have to.
Endless Love. Oh my god. Are you doing that? Seriously?
Okay, this is the Angel Jengum Ben.
Just like an
Angel
gone wrong.
Oh my goodness.
Are you
serious? Okay, okay. Well, I'll try.
So are you doing for
Walk away from the camera.
Who starts though?
No, wait. But are you comfortable doing this duet or do you have another duet that you want to do?
Yeah, like
Reunited.
Sean was saying
I can show you the world.
That's not the name of the song.
Well,
the
Holy
World.
A Whole New World.
Okay, yeah,
like,
that
one's not. You can't play.
You can't play. So what can you play?
Endless Love.
Okay, we do try.
Yeah, like this. Okay, let's try. Just give it a shot. I mean, at the end of the day, it's for entertainment, right?
Who goes first?
So you are Lionel, right?
I do Lionel.
You got the lyrics, huh?
Yeah, it's right here.
Cool.
It's very small though.
Guy first, is it?
If anything, I'll help you, Angel, because yeah, I can do the guy.
My love.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
There's only you in my life. The only thing that's right.
My first love.
Angel, please.
You're every breath that I take. You're every step I make. And I
want to share all my love with you. No one else will do. And you're a your eyes, they tell me how much you care. Oh, yes, you will always be my endless love.
Oh, nice.
Once again, the world tour is
happening. Tissue paper, please.
You know, once the karaoke joints open up, that's it. It's a date. Let's all go.
I love karaoke.
Let's all go.
Yeah, very happy.
Nice.
Very happy.
Thanks, Jing Jing. Jing Jing Jung Jung.
Jing Jing Johan.
You can also call him Johan.
Yes. Johan means champion, right?
That's right.
Wow.
Does it? Malay is second language.
Drop pen.
Huh? You fail?
Me.
Who?
Malay second language also.
You fail?
Fail.
Now at least you know what Johan means.
Yeah. Oh, champions.
Champions.
But you know,
English also fail. English.
Johan used to perform. Like, how many times a week?
And how many times a week?
Yeah.
Nights a week? Yeah.
Three
or four nights a week.
Where were the places you used to perform?
I went around. I went to Acid Bar, Timber. Last one was at Four Points.
Yeah.
Right.
So he was one of the freelancers.
I do solo. As a, you know, like plays a band.
Yeah.
Lead singer, man.
Lead singer, this guy.
I gotta ask you, what is your favorite song as lead singer? I wanna.
A lot of Foo Fighters. AC/DC.
Ooh. Wow. Yeah. Okay.
I never go into AC/DC. I have to be honest. But my favorite song, Sweet Child of Mine.
Oh, that's our number one song on the radio station. Yeah, for our greatest hits of all time.
And rightly so.
Yeah.
AC/DC, my kepala kota.
Okay, that's all the time we have.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Gurmit, for joining us today.
Lovely to be here. Thanks. Nice to see you all again and catch up with you guys. We meet soon again.
Yes.
Karaoke.
Okay.
Karaoke.
Let's do that. Before you go, because you know, people rarely see you, you know, on live on Facebook.
Yeah.
Would you like to say anything to your fans once again before we sign off?
Okay. Hey, everybody, thank you very much for tuning in for the show, but we will really appreciate if you come for the show itself because we need the money.
Come on!
Okay, thank you.
Once again, Gurmit is going to be part of A Dose of Comedy 2 at the Drama Centre, 6th to the 8th of May. You can get your tickets from ptix.com. Mm-hmm. I do believe there are only 200 tickets available because of COVID restrictions and all that.
Yep.
So you can get your tickets. And if you use the promo code 1FM today, you'll get the tickets, which would have otherwise cost $75, for $60.
That's all right. Woo! That's a good deal.
A lot of people are making noise about that on our Facebook page.
Why?
We only mentioned the promo code at the end after like 50 minutes of the show. Then he's like, I bought my tickets. Oh! I legit just bought my tickets.
No! Gurmit mentioned the promo code just now.
No, but he mentioned 8:50. They bought at 8 o'clock.
This is called a marketing strategy.
Tell them only at the end.
We love you. Sorry, everybody. We love you.
Okay, thank you, Gums. Once again, give Gums a big hand. Thank you so much. Gurmit Singh, thank you so much for watching. Share the video. Bye-bye.